So maybe you're wondering, what is Aspen Assays? It's nothing more than a process simulation. From the way I took this from the website, and I really like it because it's entirely true, is Aspen Assays is the energy industry's leading process simulation software. That is, it's in charge of process simulating energy industry, which is oil and gas, petrochemical mostly, and one of the most powerful software. And is still being used by oil and gas producers, refineries, and engineering companies for process optimization in design and operations. So once again, this is mostly used for designing and operating processes, either if you are creating a new process or if you are working in an existing process. Okay, you can check out the full definition here, Aspen Tech. They have plenty of products. Aspen Assays is one of the most important of them. So we will be working mostly in two licenses, which are the Aspen Assays crude license, which is right here. This is for the oil manager. And if you want to know if you have that license active, just check out Open Aspen Assays and go to the physical property environment. Once you're there, if you see this little barrel with the oil drop and says oil manager, then you're good to go. And we will be working with the Aspen Assays Petroleum Refining System license. Okay, so this one goes for the Petroleum Assay Manager. And this is much more powerful for identification modeling of very precise petroleum assays. So not that much working with them in the simulation per se. So if you want to know if you have that license, just check out in the same bar ribbons, you will find here the refining section, if you have petroleum assays. So just, this is pretty common, I'm pretty sure you all have them, if you have Aspen Assays access, this will be most likely present. What you might not have is the petroleum refining license. But don't worry guys, if you still have the oil manager, this is the most useful one, let's say overall, to model processes. This is much more theoretical, most likely if you work directly with a lab instead that in a plant. But anyways, we are going to see both of them, so take the most advantage of both of them. And versions, well, you could actually use any versions. I've seen people working with version 3. The most common one will be version 10, which is the new one. I got version 8.8. The similarities are, I don't know, maybe 95%. The things that changes are very little details or updates, so don't worry if you have different versions. The idea is not only to know how to use these tools, but actually understand them. Of course, someone that works with version 10 can go back to version 9 or 8 or even 7, and backwards, if someone was working with version 7, it's very easy to get used to version number 10. So don't worry, whatever version you have, you will be able to work with these tools.